Alright folks, so we are back with the next step, and that is after heat treat, grinding. And as you see, the first step, what I'm doing is doing that pretty steep bevel, you know, just flat bevel, kind of like a secondary bevel. And that helps me, you know, to, I grind it all the way to the, till I get the burr. And once the burr is created along the whole side, what it helps me is when I'm gonna be doing that flat bevels again, the, you know, grinding the whole length, it actually prevents from overheating, because that cutting edge actually is not gonna be touching the belt all the way up to like I'm almost finished. And because of the thickness of these big blades, which is actually one advantage of doing the big blades, they are a huge heat sink, so they don't overheat as much. But you still see me almost every pass, every other pass, I do cool it in the water, cool it down. Even though I could probably do it even a lot longer periods of grinding without cooling down on such a big thick blade. But it is always better to, you know, better do that than be sorry later. So first you saw that I did that pretty steep, like I don't know, 30-20 DPS on each side. Like a kind of like a secondary bevel, and then you see me grinding the flat. Now, one thing what I probably will start doing in the future is I will just keep the whole grind flat before the heat treat, because I used to do that. I used to do it that I ground it flat and convex it before heat treat, and then after the heat treat, I just did the convexing over and over. But I actually found out that it is a little better doing the flat and doing the convex is the last step right before you finish and blend all the grinds together, you know, that secondary bevel and the primary grind. So from now on I will probably do just the flat grind and then convex it on the very end of it when it's already hardened. I find it to be probably a little more time efficient too, and maybe a little easier and all that stuff. So this is still a 50 grit ceramic belt, brand new, and see, it's taking time. It still removes quite a lot of metal, and when I'm about maybe a little less than 1/4 inch from the top of the spine, and about 1/8 of an inch left over from the secondary bevel, I put that felt there. You saw me, I sprayed that spray adhesive on my felt backing, put it on the platen. I actually did put the new belt on it also for this part, because it cuts better, and it is pretty worn out after doing the all that grinding before on the hardened steel. So instead of, you know, overheating the metal and, you know, struggling with the worn out belt, it's always better to just use the belt. Also, what you can see, what I was pointing out, is little help. You see the rust, because it's O1, it rusts very really quick. You see the rust on the edge, so it actually gives you really good idea. Just like if you had the, if you were to use the blue paint, the marker, it shows you you know, what portions are already grounded and what are not. It's really nice, kind of like a marking little helper. And you see, I'm blending the bevels all together, still on the 50 grit belt. And very soon here, I will be switching the 50 grit ceramic into 100 ceramic, just to clean up the grind lines and all that stuff. It actually is looking pretty good, even with that 50 grit. With the light pressure towards the end, it already looks like a nice satin finish, but you can actually feel the grind lines. But right now I swap to that 100. I'm not sure if it's 100 or 120. Won't really make so much of a difference. But around the whole length, nice with this finer grit, just to clean up the grind lines and everything. And you saw I pointed out that I still had that original burr from the primary secondary bevel that I did. So that's what I'm trying to blend in now by raising the blade a little bit, slightly bit higher. And also, because it's a knife for somebody else, You always better to grind it not as thin as I would do normally for my blades, but just a little thicker on the edge. So I'm kind of blending that secondary bevel into the zero grind. It's you wouldn't really be able to see even that it was a secondary bevel. It's so thin on the edge that it is pretty much like a zero grind. But it is, I could see in the performance towards the end of the video, that it is not as lean, as crazy as I'm used to. But at the same time, especially with this O1 tool steel, which isn't as great as like, let's say 3V, it's still a little bit less of a risk of ruining and, you know, cracking or chipping or unnecessary rolling if you hit something really hard. So still 100 grit with the backing. You see it already, it's a very nice clean grind. Now I'm gonna swap to, I think it's 180 or 200 against ceramic belt. Every metal working I do is with ceramic belts. They just cut better, they last longer, and yes, they are a little more expensive, but they are definitely worth the money. And still the same thing again, trying to blend that that edge nice and even into that primary grind, and clean up the primary grind also with that finer belt. And now I remove the backing and I put the Scotch-Brite there. I'm cleaning the residue from the heat treat from the handle, and I'm gonna clean up the whole grind also with that Scotch-Brite. This is the fine Scotch-Brite, you see me. You want to be careful if you're doing, if you are facing the direction of the belt with the edge. You want to make sure that you're not gonna cut into the belt or mess up the edge itself. So, you know, be careful with that. It's cleaning the spine, the whole side of it. On the Scotch-Brite, it really doesn't leave any grind lines. So just like a basic cleanup of that, kind of oil residue, you know, from the quench. Gonna clean the hand a little bit too, a little less work to do when I actually will be doing the handle. That's gonna be one of the hardest parts actually. Handle on these big blades are not very easy. It's a lot of work, a lot of material removal and all that stuff. So almost done here. You're gonna see that it actually does leave a very nice satin finish, this fine Scotch-Brite belt. And the last step is actually 400 what is it, silica carbide. It's a black silica carbide belt, very fine, very abrasive. It removes metal fairly well, especially when it's new. They won't last long, but these are exceptionally well. 400, 600, this was actually the first time I tried the 400 before I did the 600. And I just sharpened it, and you saw me run it in on the piece of wood just to get rid of the burr. And this is my, I call it power strap. It's that sanding drill, sanding disc attachment for a drill, which I took one of the older, you know, sandpapers for it, and I epoxied a piece of leather on it. And it's removable hook and loop system, and it just, you know, like a power strap, it strapped the blade. You saw it, it took a couple seconds. And this is the sharpness of the blade, right off the 400 grit belt, and just those couple seconds on the power strap. And I'll just always just run it a couple times by hand on the regular strap, and you will see the sharpness. It comes off ridiculously sharp. You know, if you're talking the whole process of starting sharpening on the 400 grit to this, it is literally 2 minutes, and you end up with this sharpness, which is really, really nice. Very nice edge, very crisp edge, very sharp edge, and effortless. It took very little time. I love these very fine silica carbide belts. And I'm gonna give you a close-up of the grind also. I just want to clean it. You always have a little bit of residue from the power strap from the compound, so I always clean it with WD-40 every time when I you know, in the process of working I use WD-40, but once the blade is done I use actually that that lanolin What is it called? I always forget that name. Oh, that really cool product what I got from a friend, from a fellow YouTuber and a viewer. It's old school spray with lanolin in it, and it smells horrible, but it works great. Works great, and it's FDA approved, so you know it's food grade, which is nice. You see that really nice fine silent finish. It work out sweet. It looks nice and neat. I'm actually gonna call Smoggy here. I'm gonna ask him if he wants to leave it like this or if he wants me to dip it in this in acid, do like a acid wash, acid bath. I'll see some basic testing. I wanna see how it cuts, how it bites. You know, if it won't roll on me, if it's not overheated or something. Some basic cutting, which it shouldn't. Still a great cutter. It's not the crazy cutter like some other of the blades that I did for myself, but like I said, rather have it a little thicker than have it super thin. And you know, having a somebody who's not used to such a grinds and such a big blades to chop with it crooked or something, twist the blade in a cut and break it. And you see it actually has really nice penetration in chops. These are very very easy chops, which is a wrist flick. You see how deep it bites. It is gonna be a really nice outdoor blade, good chopper, and I really hope Smoggy will enjoy this blade, because I think it's gonna be cool, definitely, especially with that blade handle material he got from Guy Noble, Guy Carter. That's gonna be pretty sweet. Hopefully soon. Hopefully I'll try to do it tomorrow or over the weekend. And of course, do it on the make a video out of it too. Gonna do the whole process, everything, the handle and the shit also. So I hope you enjoyed it, guys. Thank you for watching. Take care, stay safe, and remember, don't cut yourself.